Hey y'all, I'm Mandy, and this is Mandy in the Making. Welcome back to my channel, and welcome back to another episode of Winter Dinners, where I'm going to show you three really easy meals. So usually I show you a couple of meals, and then we do something called a Subbie supper segment. Did I say that right? Subbie supper segment? Say that three times fast. But we're gonna change things up. We were really craving tacos tonight, so we're doing taco night. And this recipe came from a friend of mine named Christy, and she sent it to me a couple of months ago, and she said it's great as a side dish for Mexican night. So I'm finally getting to try it, and we're really excited. So before I tell you a little bit about Christy, I just wanted to say, if you have a recipe that you think that we would like to try, I would love for you to send it to us. Just email me at mandyinthemaking2018@gmail.com and just put in the subject line Subbie Supper so that I know. And if we decide that we want to give it a try, I will find out a little bit more about you so I can share it here on this segment, and we will give your recipe a try and do a taste test. So my friend who sent this over, her name is Christy, like I mentioned. We actually used to work together a little over 10 years ago. That's how we met. I worked with both her and her husband, but she is the mom to two little boys, and she said that she loves to be in the kitchen cooking and baking. She enjoys both, and she lives not too far from me. She actually jokingly said that she was going to come over for a cameo for her segment. I told her to come on, but she ain't here yet. So this side dish for Mexican night is just sweet corn and zucchini. It's got some taco seasoning in it. Sounds really simple, a little on the healthier side, and let's do it. Next, I'm gonna chop up just a little bit of sweet onion. Okay, I've got a large skillet that I've heated to medium-high heat. We're gonna add in a couple of tablespoons of butter. Let that melt down. So first we're gonna saute our zucchini. I've got about 2 cups here, maybe a little less, and our onion. We're gonna saute this for probably about 5 minutes until our onion is really translucent and soft. I was supposed to add 3 tablespoons, so I just added my last tablespoon in. Okay, it's been about 5 minutes. We're gonna add in some sweet corn. Mine is frozen, so it's gonna take a minute for this to heat right back up. We're also gonna add in a couple of teaspoons of taco seasoning. And 2 more tablespoons of butter. Good?
Mmm.
Cole likes it too.
Wow.
Is that a
so
good
the taco
time?
Seasoning is great, but listen, the first thing that I got
was
the sweetness of the corn and the butter.
Okay.
It was just really coming out in the beginning. And then you get the heat in the back now.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But the way that the zucchini and the corn pair with the butter.
So good.
And the seasonings? Because I know there's probably garlic.
Well, I mean, it's taco seasoning, so.
Taco seasoning,
yeah. It's got garlic powder in there.
Garlic powder, yeah. Man. Yes. This is a great side for taco night.
Mm-hmm. Okay, awesome. Cole is all about it. And I'm kind of surprised, Christy, because Cole doesn't really usually like the texture of cooked zucchini, but he is over there chowing down, so that's a good thing. This is delicious. Thank you, Christy. I just remembered something. When Christy and I worked together, we would have, I think like once a month, we would do something at work on our floor for all the birthdays. It would be called birthday breakfast or birthday something. So if it was your birthday month, you didn't bring in any food, but everybody else brought in food. Christy was always such a great cook. She shared with me several recipes, and I still have them in your handwriting, Christy. I'm pretty sure. But one of them I've made several times, and it's pineapple, upside down pineapple biscuits. Do y'all remember me making those?
I do remember that.
Yeah, that came from Christy. So, and she shared a couple of other recipes with me. I can't remember, but Christy has always been great in the kitchen. I have not always been great in the kitchen, but thank you, Christy. Okay, y'all, it is our second night. Tonight is another really quick dinner. I think last night it was like 20 minutes. Tonight is gonna be probably 20, 25 minutes as well, which is my kind of night. We are having baked honey garlic chicken tenders. It's got a lot of our favorite flavors in it. I know this one's gonna be good. To get started, I'm just gonna add our chicken tenders into a quart size Ziploc bag. I don't have too many of them, about a pound, pound and a half worth. I am gonna let these marinate for just about 15 minutes in the fridge while I get the other things that we're gonna have for dinner together. So to this, I'm gonna add some soy sauce, not a lot. A little ginger. You could always do fresh ginger if you wanted to, but I like having this in the fridge. And a little bit of garlic. Okay, I'm just gonna close this up and make sure it all gets kind of distributed evenly, and I'm gonna stick it in the fridge while I prep our side dishes for tonight. One other thing I need to do is to preheat my oven to 400. Okay, so I decided to go the easy route tonight for side dishes. I just don't feel like cooking, honestly. I'm just gonna be really honest. So once I get this in the oven, I'm going to heat up some broccoli from the freezer, and then we're also gonna do frozen riced cauliflower. I'm gonna do it on the stovetop instead of in the microwave, just so I can add some Parmesan cheese and some seasonings to it as it's steaming or cooking, but simple is the name of the game. It's time to assemble all of our chicken tenders, so let's do that now. So I've got them here. We're gonna dip them in egg. I have two eggs here, and then panko breadcrumbs. I have about a cup, maybe a little less. And then it's gonna go onto this baking sheet lined with parchment paper. I've got the panko breadcrumbs sitting on it so that the parchment paper will stay in place for now. So into the egg, and then into the breadcrumbs. And don't worry, we're gonna have plenty of flavor with this because we're gonna be making a sauce on the stove while these are in the oven. These are done. They're going in a 400 degree oven for about 15 minutes just until they're done. For our sauce, I've got this small saucepan. I'm gonna be adding some sriracha sauce, some honey, some soy sauce, some garlic, and then we'll make, after it comes to a boil, we'll make a cornstarch slurry and add that in to help thicken. I am gonna make a little more sauce than what it calls for just because that's how we do things around here. It calls for 1/3 cup of honey, so let's add that in. A couple of tablespoons of soy sauce. The recipe calls for about 1 tablespoon of sriracha, so we'll add just a little bit more than that. And I did a little more than a couple of tablespoons of soy sauce too. We need 3 cloves of garlic. Okay, let's just wait for this to come up to a simmer. I'm gonna stir it all together really good. We're waiting on our sauce to come to a simmer. I've got this pan heating to medium heat. I'm just gonna add in some frozen riced cauliflower. Okay, it has come up to a boil. I had to make my cornstarch slurry really quickly. It's just 1 tablespoon of cornstarch and 1 tablespoon of water. Let's add that in. So this is just gonna thicken it really well. And our tenders are about to come out of the oven, and we'll toss them in the sauce. I'm gonna go ahead and pour a little bit of the sauce over this bottom layer. Okay, this is where a recipe kind of failed me. It said to just toss them, but the breading starts to come apart. So my advice is when you make this, just pour the sauce over each individual serving. Don't try and do what I just did because it didn't work as well as I hoped it did. It would, but that's okay. We're gonna make it work, but just take my advice. Okay, so our riced cauliflower is starting to heat up. I'm gonna add some seasonings. You know which seasoning I'm adding. I'm also gonna add a little Parmesan cheese to our riced cauliflower, and this will be done in just a couple of minutes. We're really just waiting for all of the water to evaporate, and then this will be completely ready.
Sweet and spicy? Sweet and sour?
Honey garlic.
Honey garlic. Honey garlic chicken.
That's right.
Honey garlic chicken. Sweet honey garlic chicken, though, right? gonna have a little sweetness to it.
I don't know about this. Well, yeah, it's got honey in it, so that's sweet.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sweet, garlicky flavor, a little bit of spice in there.
Sriracha.
Got it. That's exactly what that is. Okay.
You like that?
Yes, I love it. It's really good. It reminds me a little bit of orange chicken.
Really?
Yes.
That's a good thing. Yeah, we love really orange good. Chicken.
Very tasty. I love it. And I love the fact that, I mean, look at that. It like cuts like butter.
Okay. I was a little skeptical when I didn't. So I even made more sauce than it called for, and it still didn't quite cover them completely. But, you know, that may have just been something I did wrong, but.
Just increase your sauce.
Yeah.
You know, and you'll have plenty, and.
I'll definitely make more sauce next time.
It's really good.
All right, try the rice cauliflower and see if it's got enough flavor.
Ooh.
Rice cauliflower is good?
Oh, yeah.
Awesome.
Oh, wow. Definitely get the Parmesan cheese.
Yeah.
For sure.
Okay.
And the anti-no-nos is coming in.
Yeah.
With the garlic and all the good seasonings in
there. You know what? I just remembered. I didn't put anti-no-nos on our broccoli. I need to go grab that.
Shame, shame, shame.
I know, right? Lou, you say hello? No, you did. That was very nice. Don't let this fool you. It doesn't look like it has a ton of flavor, but it does. That sriracha is definitely coming in with the heat at the end. And then you get that honey. It's really good. And the garlic flavor, the rice cauliflower, so creamy and good. And then, of course, just the broccoli. But I almost forgot to come on here and tell y'all. I'm just too busy eating.
Hey y'all, it is the third night and tonight we're keeping it simple yet again. I feel like the theme of this entire week was just simple. Tonight we are having Greek chicken bowls. This would be a great thing for you to prep at the beginning of the week and just fix them as you're going to eat them. But we're really excited. We love the Greek flavors. We love feta cheese. This has both. Let's get started.
First, we're going to start by marinating the chicken. We're going to let it sit in the refrigerator for probably 30 to 45 minutes. Here's all of our ingredients. I've already added 3 pretty small chicken breasts to this bag. Let's add all the ingredients in.
We're gonna start with just a couple of tablespoons of olive oil. Next, we need the juice of 1 lemon, about 3 tablespoons worth of juice. I'm not too worried if the seeds get in here. 1 tablespoon of white wine vinegar. I've got some seasonings here, about 2 tablespoons of oregano, 1 teaspoon of garlic powder, and 1/2 teaspoon of thyme. And then about 1/2 a teaspoon each of salt and pepper. Let's close this up and just massage it all in, and then we'll put it in the refrigerator and it'll be ready in just a little while for us to cook.
We're gonna get started on chopping up the ingredients for our cucumber salad that goes with our Greek chicken bowls. So the only things I really need to chop up are right here, 4 Roma tomatoes. We only need like 1/4 a cup of red onion, so maybe even half of this half of a red onion, and then this English cucumber.
So I am gonna cut my Kalamata olives in half. I've got a good handful here. I may get a few more, just depending. We love Kalamata olives, but if you don't love them, you could leave them out, or you could even do black olives. I forgot we had some roasted red peppers in our fridge, so I'm gonna add those to this as well. I think they'll taste really, really good in this. We're gonna add in some feta cheese. I think it calls for 1/2 cup. I'm just gonna kinda go with it. We love feta cheese. We need 1 tablespoon of olive oil, 2 tablespoons of white wine vinegar. Here I've got 1 teaspoon of garlic powder, 1 teaspoon of oregano, and 1/4 teaspoon of dried dill weed. And I'm adding 1/2 teaspoon of salt and 1/2 teaspoon of pepper. I'm just gonna toss all of this and stick it in the fridge.
Now we're just gonna make our rice in the Instant Pot. I've got jasmine rice here. I'm gonna do 1 cup of it. I'm gonna go rinse this really well until the water runs clear. Okay, let's add that into our Instant Pot. I'm also adding 1 cup of water. And we are gonna pressure cook this for 3 minutes on high, and then I will let it naturally release for about 10 minutes and we should be good. So it's been about 1 hour. This has had plenty of time to marinate. I'm gonna remove the chicken from the bag, and we are going to blot it with a paper towel just to get the excess off. We don't want it to
too much marinade on it when we put it in a hot skillet.
Okay, this skillet is heated to medium heat. I'm gonna add just about a tablespoon of olive oil. Okay, we are gonna cook this until they are completely done. I've got one that's a little bit thicker than the other two, so I'll probably have to remove the other two first. But you just wanna cook it until the internal temperature is 165, and then we'll let them rest for a little bit before we slice them to go in our Greek bowls.
Cole's already into it over there.
I am excited about this. Oh man, it just smells. It got that Greek seasoning smell to it. Oh man, I'm so excited.
He was not in the kitchen for the making of this. Neither was Cole, so they have no clue.
Mmm. Wow. Man, there's a lot of flavor in this. It is the perfect Greek salad.
Yep.
I mean, if you can call it a salad, I guess you can. Because
yeah, I mean, it's got a cucumber salad in there, but it's also got the rice.
This is exactly what you would expect with the Greek seasonings and everything in there. One of our favorite restaurants that has the Greek salad tastes just like this.
Yeah.
Really, really, really good.
Okay, Cole won't slow down over there. Like, he's shoveling it in his mouth, so. Oh, we get a face too, y'all. We get a face.
This is amazing.
Yeah.
You know it's good if Cole comes on camera. I'm just saying.
And I'm not a fan of rice.
Right.
This just...
But you love the rice with this.
It's amazing.
Look at that. He's almost done. Okay. That means it's time for me to eat.
This is one of my favorite meals I've made in a very long time.
Rice. Right. This is so good.
This is going to be in a favorites video. You can guarantee that.
This is so good. I only have one regret, and that's that I didn't make more. I should have made more. Wow.
Thank y'all so much for being here and for watching this week's winter dinners. I hope you enjoyed it. We really had some great dinners this week, and I feel like they weren't quite as heavy either. Give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. And also, if you haven't joined my YouTube family, I would love for you to hit that red subscribe button before you go. Let's look at some bloopers.
Hey y'all, I'm Mandy. Stop. We were doing so good.
Beep. Tell them about it.
Why don't you show yourself? Do the face you were just doing. This is what I deal with.
Yeah.
So y'all think I'm just crazy, just laughing all the time, but right. It's because this doofus is behind the camera acting a fool.
You are crazy.
I just opened the sriracha sauce and it like, yeah, it's on the cabinet. It got all over my hand. It exploded. Hold on, I'll show you. There it is. It's up here on the cabinet. It's on the microwave. Thanks, sriracha.
I'm also gonna add just a little Parmesan cheese to our, it's not open. It's not open.